Welcome everyone to Dynamics Bytes on user security governance, aka USG. I'm Saurabh Bharati, a senior solution architect at FastTrack. This is part 3 of Dynamics 365 Bytes for USG. Today's agenda is to understand security categories in USG and why it is important. Then we will have a demo of creation of the security categories manually and through import. We will also look at some of the parameters under the USG. Categories are used for an aggregation in the process role maintain module. You can define categories that helps you to save a new role under a given workstream or department. We strongly recommend that you complete this setup correctly. In this way, you help reduce the development cost when security upgrades are required. There are two ways to create security categories. Create a new category from the scratch or import from the different company or the different environment. Now, let's look at the demo in the system. Now, before we start creating security categories, let's look at the feature which we need to enable under the feature management. So if you go to feature management, you will find the user security governance feature here. Now, to create a new security category, you need to navigate to the system admin. Under the system admin, security governance, and then you go and create the security categories here. I have created two categories, and these categories are, let's say, how I want to group my roles, which I'm creating based on the processes. I have created, let's say, three security categories here with the name finance APAR and operations purchase. I can provide the name which I need here. Once that is done, I can just save these categories here. Now, also I can export these categories by clicking on backup as XML, and then I can export one security category, or I can export all the categories in the one go. And also I can select the type, the user security governance or the security configuration, or I want to export both together. Now let's say if I select both here today, and then all the categories, and I will export, and this is going to export a XML file. Now I'm into different environment, and here also, let's say I need to create security categories. One option is that I click on the new and create all the security categories. Another option is that I have exported my XML from the other environment, and then I can import those categories using the restore from XML, and then I can browse my file using the browse option here. Once that is done, I can select the security relation action, which is to create here, and I have selected the type governance for the configuration. I can click on OK to import all the security categories. Once that is done, I have all my security categories imported in this particular environment or in this particular legal entity. Now, the next thing which you want to check is the parameters under USG. Now, to go for parameters, I can go to system admin. Under the setup, I have parameters for security governance setup. I can click on this. And there are some basic parameters which we need to specify, some general parameter for checking similarities and the level of similarity we want to check. And do we want to allow the unpublished objects? The another important one here is for our one of the report, which is user aging activity report, where we can define the buckets for number of days you want to see the user activity in an aging term. This is similar to our customer aging report, and we can define similarly for our user aging as well. That's it for this byte. See you in the next one. Thank you.